How did scriptures come to existence?
Okay, what is the source of scriptures? Very interesting thing. Where do the scriptures come from? Of course, we have talked about the Shruti scripture, the scripture of authority. How did they come? Did they fall out of the sky? We're walking in the forest in India, boom, they hit us on the head, this is the Vedas. How did the scriptures come about? Very important question. Where do they come from? Interesting thing is this. We said those individuals, those people who are able to experience God or spirit, Atman, I am that. Actually, there are people like that. The latest one that I can recommend is Ramana Maharshi. He was in South India until 1950. They said, we know what you're talking about, Atman, I am the spirit, I'm not the body. And when they wanted to do operation on his arm, on his shoulder, we said, would give you anesthetic. What anesthetic? I am not the body, I'm the spirit. Just cut. It was like that. You saw people like that, yes. These are really experienced people, people experience religion. So where do the Shrutis come from? The scripture of authority, they come from these people. When they experience God and spirit, etc., they become very vibrant. They're called rishis. They become very vibrant, and then they give expression to their experience. What experience? How does this Atman experience is? Or how does God look? What is the experience of God? They talk about it, and they become Shruti. The Shrutis come from enlightened people in the Hindu tradition who say God is a matter of experience, for not just book learning. They used to be copying the same old book. They say, we experience God, and now we'll tell you about it. And when they open their mouth, that's called the Vedas. This is the definition of Vedas. The Shrutis, scripture of authority. People who experience, tell us about their experience, is called the Vedas. This is the power of, this is where the Shrutis come from, the scripture of authority come from.